Hello. In this experiment, we'll be showing you how to weld a box section bridge. But not using metal, as you might expect, we're using chocolate. We'll see how much stronger the welded bridge is compared to a simple plank bridge. Most welded bridges are made from steel, which melts at 1,500 degrees C. You need the heat from an electric arc or a laser beam to weld that. Luckily, there's a material which can be welded with the heat from hot water, chocolate. So, that's what we're using today, as the welding engineer, Dr. Philippa Moore, explains.
So, to weld our chocolate bridges, what I've got here is a tall, straight-sided bottle. This is just filled with hot water from the kettle, and this is going to be our heat source for doing the welding. I'm also going to use a jig, which is a plastic tray. You could use a shallow yogurt pot with right angles cut out so that when I put in my welded chocolate bars, I can set them at the right angle. So this will be quite useful. And of course, I need some chocolate. You're going to need 4 bars of chocolate to make a box section bridge. And this type of bar is quite good because it's got a quite nice thick edge to one side. You've got plenty of chocolate to melt there. So I start off getting 2 pieces of chocolate. And you melt the edges against the hot surface of the wine bottle. Once they start to melt and get sticky, and then place them in the jig. And the good thing about having a jig is you can take a little bit of time to position them nice and carefully and make it as good as you can. We need 2 right angles to make each box section bridge, so we'll make another one. There we go, nice and sticky. And into the jig, and we're just line that up nice and carefully. And there we go, there are right angles, and we've done our first set of welds. What we'll do, we'll put those in the fridge, and here I've got 2 which have been in the fridge already, and they're nice and set at right angles. And now to complete the box section bridge, I'm then going to do exactly the same thing with these 2 right angles, but I'm going to melt both of the edges at the same time. It's a little bit more tricky with the right angles, but by the time you've done the 2 right angles, you should be fairly expert at this. And until they're nice and sticky. There, look at that. And then we place those in the jig. And this can be a little bit trickier to align these up perfectly, but take your time to make as good a box section as you can. And there we go, that's our welded box section bridge. We put that one in the fridge to cool or leave it for 20 minutes. And then we can come on to doing the mechanical testing. So we start off with a single plank. So here's a single bar, and we'll test this one to see how strong is just a single bar on its own. I've got here some 50 gram weights and some 100 gram weights, so we'll start loading it up in the middle. 100 grams. That's 150 grams. And it's going at 150 grams. So the single plank fails at only 150 grams. Now I'm going to take a box section bridge. This one has been in the fridge so that the welds are nice and set. So the previous bridge failed at 150 grams, so let's start with a 200 gram weight. That's 400. That's 600. So already 4 times the weight that the single plank failed at. 800. And we're going to need a kilogram, so let's try. I've got here some kilograms and some half kilograms. And a half. That's 2. 2.5. That's 3. 3.5. Oops. Steady. 4.5, you know. Let's keep going. And then the other one fell just 150 grams. So now that's 5 kilograms. So this bridge failed at 5 kilograms, which is over 30 times the load that the single plank bridge could withstand. So why is the box section so much stronger than the single plank? Well, it's all to do with how flexible the beams are. Everybody knows how to break a piece of chocolate. You bend it, it snaps. So it's the same thing. You imagine your plank bridge as a ruler, And when it's nice and flat, it's very easy to bend it. And once it reaches a critical amount of bend, then it will break. So it's basically how much you can bend your bridge before it will snap. If you turn your ruler onto its side and have a tall, thin bridge, suddenly it's a lot harder to bend it. You can't bend the ruler anywhere near as easily. It takes a lot more force to try and bend it. And that's effectively what your box section bridge is two tall, thin beams being held together in a box. And it takes a lot more force to be able to bend those that beam sufficiently to actually break the chocolate. So that's why your box section is so much stronger. And the good thing about this experiment is once you've finished it, you can eat the chocolate.
Well, both of these bridges show that welding is important in industry. It allows you to build structures that are stronger or larger or better than simple components alone. It's important to get the welding quality as good as possible. That's why the Welding Institute helps industry to produce better welds. If you enjoyed this experiment, do try it for yourself at home or at school. And why not think about the properties of other chocolate bars and how they might fail under load? Look at metal bridges when you're out and about. Can you see where they're welded? And what other structures could you weld with chocolate? Above all, have fun with welding.